How do you go about mounting the Twinox 4 bracket? In our first video of this little tutorial, we have shown you all that you need to get started. Ready? We first need to take care of the cable coming out of the Twinox 4. Take the cable and first feed it through the middle opening of the bracket seal. Make sure that the seal is facing the bracket case with a protruding edge. It is also important that the angular end of the bracket case will be flush to the angular end of the bracket seal. Now feed the cable through the bracket case like this. Clamp the cable into the strain relief in the bracket case so that there is still room enough for a little loop. Next, place the bracket at the rear of the Twinox 4 stick and align the seal correctly. We're using the outward facing holes and two of the M5 screws to mount the bracket to the Twinox 4. Put in the ball sockets and the spacer seals and only then screw in the screws. Tighten the screws equally until the seals lie flush. Make sure that the seals don't slip while doing so, because this might result in potential leaks. There is one thing left to do in this step, and that is tightening the cable gland until it is flush with the bracket case. Unscrew the cable gland and move the two parts separately. That makes it easier to attach it to the bracket base. First, fix the little conduit to the bracket base. Then tighten the counterpart onto the cable gland conduit. Hold the cable so it won't twist and turn in the process. So now we have attached the mounting bracket to our Twinox sticks. You're now ready to actually mount the Twinox 4 to the machine, but that's another story, which we're going to tell you in the next clip of our tutorial. Thanks for watching.